Hey kids, I'm Tim.
And I'm Stevie.
And welcome to Children's Church at Home. I hope you've had a great week so far. Today's gonna be an awesome day. Do you know why? Because we get to learn more about God and His Word.
Hello, welcome to our Children's Church. Today I have actually the last story of our Bible storybook for you. This is a really wonderful story and it's called God's Wonderful City. So this is kind of how it's all wrapping up. I'm going to read that to you quick, all right? So Paul and the two disciples, we have Peter and we have John. They wrote a lot of letters to different churches to tell about Jesus. Have you ever written a letter to anybody before? You can tell them all sorts of things, but they were telling them what Jesus had taught them. And so these letters were really appreciated by different Christians and by different people. Every time they gathered in church, they took these letters and they read them over and over again so people could learn about Jesus and everything that he did. Then there was a disciple named John. You ever heard of John? Thumbs up. We have John. He has been one of Jesus' closest friends. He lived longer than any of the other disciples. He became a very old man. John spent all his life telling people about Jesus, and he traveled far away to different countries. Later in his life, John was forced to stay alone on a small island. So some people didn't agree with what he was doing, so they put him on this little island all by himself. Not very nice. In this way, the enemies, they hoped that he would stop telling people about Jesus, but it didn't happen that way. This is a really pretty picture. I don't know if you can see it, but it's showing the rainbow and Jesus. One day, John had a very special experience. Suddenly, he could see right into heaven. What? That's crazy. So he could see where God was. He could see Jesus dressed in a white robe, and he saw God's throne surrounded by a rainbow. Have you ever seen a rainbow? It's always so beautiful. And all around it, he could see angels, and they were singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the God Almighty." Later, some of the angels showed John what will happen in the future. John wrote down all of what he saw and all of what he heard. Then he sent letters about it to his friends so he could tell other Christians what John had seen and had been told about the future. That would be pretty amazing and pretty lucky to have that happen. When John was looking into heaven, he saw a very special city. It was the most beautiful city he had ever seen. Have you ever been to a really beautiful place? Everything was covered with gold and with pearls. Whoa, he saw the city where God and Jesus lives. Even the streets were made of gold. So could you imagine walking around and the ground was made of gold? In the middle of the city was a beautiful river, and along the river were trees. The most wonderful fruits were growing on trees. I love fruits. And when people eat the fruit, they live forever. What? Heaven is a place where there's no more pain, no more suffering, no more sickness, no more death. Only good and wonderful things happen there, and Jesus is waiting for us to be with him. He is preparing a home for us, and there's plenty of room there. And we will live there forever with Jesus and with God and all of the people that believe. That is such a great way to end, and I have a little kind of coloring page for you to make really special. I put lots of glitter on mine, so if you have any glitter at home, some of it's kind of falling off of me. We have the house where you can put glitter, you can decorate, and then I put gold glitter to represent those gold streets. And from John 14:2, it says, "In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you."
For our song this week, we're going to sing a song that reminds us that God is good all the time. This song is called Jesus in the Morning. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Love him. Love him, love him, love him in the morning, love him at the noontime. Love him, love him, love him when the sun goes down. Praise him, Praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him in the morning, praise Him at the noontime. Praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him when the sun goes down. Thank Him. Thank Him, thank Him. Thank Him in the morning, thank Him at the noontime. Thank Him, thank Him. Thank Him when the sun goes down. Serve Him. Serve Him, serve Him. Serve Him in the morning, serve Him at the noontime. Serve Him, serve Him. Serve Him when the sun goes down. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus in the morning, Jesus at the noontime. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Jesus when the sun goes down. Jesus when the sun goes down. Thank you so much. Let's fold our hands. We'll pray together the Lord's Prayer. We pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. All right, thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you sang so loud. Have fun doing those crafts, and we'll see you next week.